Hello everyone, welcome to Tech and Travel. Tesla Model 3 in its 54 kilowatt standard range plus configuration has a rated range of 415 kilometers. This is about 260 miles. However, in practice, one observes a range of about 300 kilometers. That's what I've gotten over the last 9 months of owning Tesla Model 3. The big question always in my mind has been, why is my observed range 30% lesser than the rated range? Recently, Tesla came up with a new energy app in its software update 2022.36, and that gave us a lot of transparency on how the battery is consumed by various elements. Here's a sneak peek of the app. Now, this energy app is pretty cool. It shows you how the energy consumption is broken down by various aspects. As opposed to going through each of these things in detail, let me directly go to the results and show you what I've gotten until now. We did three different tests on our Tesla Model 3, and I got essentially three different results. One, we are aware that the rated range is 415 kilometers. In my test 1, I got a rated range of exactly 300 kilometers. In my test 2, I got much lower. I got close to 250 kilometers, which is just about 154 miles. And in my test 3, I got more than 300. I got 324 kilometers, which is just northwards of 200 miles. So the question is, why does it differ as much as it does, even in these three tests? So let's go deeper and figure out how does it really differ. Now, one simple formula, and consumption is nothing but battery used divided by kilometers driven. For a full charge of battery, 54 kilowatt hour, if you get 300 kilometers from it, then your battery consumption per kilometer is about 180 watt hour. It's just simple math here. So now, converting the other chart, which was, I've converted that now into the consumption numbers. Obviously, the rated consumption is the lowest. You know, it takes the lowest amount of watt hours to travel every kilometer. And that's about 130 watt hour per kilometer. My test one, which gave me a range of about 300 kilometers, is at 180 watt hour per kilometer. Test two, which was pretty bad, had a much higher consumption at 218 watt hour per kilometer. And test 3 is about 167 watt hour per kilometer. So now let's start to understand how the consumption works. Firstly, let's look at the rated range. And you know, again, using these formulas and all the things that we got from the Tesla app, here is what we found. The rated consumption, which by the way is WLTP certified, has three different components. One, pure driving, which is the energy that you need to overcome resistance. That is at 112 in the rated range or the WLTP test done. Then the climate consumption is about 8 watt hour per kilometer. And then everything else, which ranges from the computers on board to all the electronics, to devices, lights, everything else is about 10 watt hour per kilometer. And if you add these three numbers, that's where you get 130 watt hour per kilometer, which is the rated range. Our test one, which gave us a range of 300 kilometers and therefore a consumption of 180 watt hour per kilometer, let's see how it breaks down. So one very interesting is that the driving did not change as much. Rated is 112, we got 116 in this. So pure driving did not add too much to the consumption. Then there is an elevation part, which honestly I would like to include within driving itself. That's a small portion which is not part of rated, but in real driving world, you will go up the flyovers, there'll be some elevation that you'll observe. So that adds a small tiny bit, 6 watt hour. The big difference is from the climate or the aircon. The rated was only 8 watt hour per kilometer, but we ended up consuming 28 watt hour per kilometer when it came to climate, which is essentially aircon or heater working. Now, the next part was also higher than rated. the electronics, devices, lights, etc., the computer there, that is rated to have 10 watt hour per kilometer, but we got about 16. Now, if you sum up all these numbers, you'll get to about 170. Beyond that, we consumed about 11 watt hour per kilometer, that is the colors in blue here, when the vehicle was parked, in two different ways. One is simply vehicle standby. So if you just leave Tesla and do not touch it for multiple days, it'll still consume small battery every day, just to keep its computers running and just to be in standby mode. It's no different from how your television works. Next, there is also park screen time, and that is 5, which is essentially when the vehicle was not running, we were still inside the car, but let's say watching a Netflix movie, or you know, just being inside the car and letting the aircon run. So that consumed 5 watt hour per kilometer. So this was interesting overall. As you can see, we go from 130 rated to 180 overall, and the biggest difference here is climate, then a little bit on the electronic devices, and then the entire standby time, which is not included in the rated range, and rightly so. Let's move to test number 2, which was the worst of all our tests in terms of consumption. So it had the highest possible consumption. The surprising thing here is that the driving part did not change as much at all. In fact, it gave us results better than test 1, including the elevation side, right? So driving and elevation combined was just 118, pretty close to the rated range. What really expanded here and what really went up is climate, from 8 in rated to 42 that we got, which is nearly 5x more. Electronic devices, I would say, was in the same ballpark as test 1. The other things that went up here is the park screen time. As opposed to 0 in rated, 5 in test 1, this was 20. And this was because I spent multiple hours, maybe 4 to 5 hours in the car during the cycle. All in all, you know, I spent about 36 watt hour per kilometer, which is in blue here, purely for vehicle standby, which obviously is not part of the rated. Lastly, test number 3, which was the most efficient test that we got, and it gave us 324 kilometers of range. So let's look at the numbers here. 1, the driving in red, it was better than rated, we got at 103. Climate was pretty much similar to test 1, it was at 28. My electronics consumption was at 15, again, slightly higher than rated, but still within what I got in other tests as well. And the park screen time and the vehicle standby time was also on the lower side in this test. So all in all, I got a number of 167 watt hour per kilometer in test 3, which is still about 25% higher than the rated. So now, having understood that breakdown, let's get into the overall verdict. Having done all these three tests, what we can conclude is essentially 4 key important things. Number 1, driving consumption is approximately in line with the rated, which is, by the way, WLTP certified. If you go into the details, those tests are conducted fairly well. Climate is the biggest gap. I must say, the test underestimate. I went into details of it and I found that the WLTP tests are essentially conducted at 23 degrees. So to me, climate is the biggest driver of the difference or the delta that you see between the rated range and the actual range that you see. Number 3, at low city speeds, if you're stuck in traffic lights, if you're stuck in traffic jams, it does impact your range quite a bit. And lastly, there is this aspect of parked vehicle consumptions. And all I would say is that, if possible, avoid multiple hours of using climate and screen time while parked. Hope you guys found this useful. Please do let me know what you think about it in the comments below. For more such unbiased reviews and for the latest on tech and travel, subscribe to our channel, Tech and Travel.